gathered not to elevate ourselves, but to show love. Can you meet yourself, please? I want you to tell Jesus you love him. Because he is Alpha and Omega. He is the beginning and the end. Everything about life is Jesus, from Genesis to Revelation. Father, we thank you for that ministration. We thank you because we are gathered unto you, not to demand anything from you, but to show that we love you. Because once we love you, everything will be added to us. Take all the glory and adoration. As usual, meet us in every point of our need, in the mighty name of Jesus. I yield myself, my members to you, Lord. Take over. Holy Spirit, take over. As usual, let me diminish. Let Jesus Christ increase. Thank you, Lord, because we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Brethren, that was hot. To God be the glory. We are talking about the importance of family. I will just throw more light into what she said. There are five types of families. One is the biological family, father, mother, children, and all that. She has dwelt very well on that. There are other types of families. The second one is adoption. If you go to motherless babies, so you adopt boys and girls, they constitute members of your family. The next one is spiritual family. Like gathering of saints, people of like mind, like as we are here gathered today, it's Pentium family. Next one is extended family. Grandmother, grandfather, living with children and all that. And the last one, association. Association you keep. Some belong to cults, some belong to godly families. These are all families. But which one do you have to belong to? Godly families. You must differentiate yourself from the ungodly and join the godly. Because why? God, has removed us from the kingdom of darkness, where the Satan reigns, to the kingdom of light, where his only son, begotten son, operates. So first, you must know which family you have to belong to. Why are families very important? Like she said, I'll have to amplify some points. Families provide protection and of course, love, bonding. Families work together to achieve a particular goal. They provide comfort for you, like we normally do in Pentium Ministries family. They aid you socially, to be socially responsible. Families discipline and respect one another. These are all components and qualities of importance of families. How do we enforce strong families? How do we bond together? You have to build trust. Families should respect themselves and reverence themselves, of course, due to trust. Whatever you say you have to do, you have to do it. It's not when you say you are in Sokoto, you find out that you are in Kafanchan. No. Your word should be your bond. Whatever you say, you should mean it, and you should keep to it, and you should be sincere. Trust. Most important point is family members should fear God. Remember, I'm not talking of only biological family. I've told you 46 different categories of families. Whatever association you belong to, take fear of God as ultimate. What will Jesus say? How will Jesus behave? What will be the outcome of Jesus' thinking? Let people see you and see Jesus in you, so that you deserve. Commitment. You must be committed. Audience, you must be committed to anything you are assigned to do. It's not when you are asked to do something Let's assume your pastor tells you to do something, you agree, but you go and do opposite. No. Or when your leader tells you to do something, you go and do something opposite. No. You must be committed. Because you are not doing this unto man, but unto God. Remember, everybody here was sent by God. And your leader was put there by God. So you must respect the leader, just like the leader should respect you. That's about discipline. Family is supposed to pray together, pray things together, plan together. Even in a Pantheon ministry, I remember we always have fellowship together in terms of prayers, and even what we're doing now, we are planning together and all that. There's energy that comes out when you do things in common, when you do things together, provided it's within the confinement of Jesus. Plan your vacations if it's biological, by families. Plan to have common hobbies. If you are associated by your family, you plan picnic, you plan things together. Remember, they say families that pray together stay together. Intercede, very, very important. You intercede for one another, pray for one another. Even if the person doesn't want you to pray for him, because he's a member of your family, in terms of association, in terms of spiritual togetherness and all that, you pray, intercede. Because when somebody in the family is affected negatively, it will affect everybody. That's the essence of being together as family. Now, we have to pray. You know, Satan is a bad Satan. Very bad, wicked Satan. Families were created by God, both biological, spiritual, and otherwise. So, the easiest way for the family, for the society to be affected is devil attacking the families, attacking associations, attacking biological, sociological, and all that. Because they say when you hit the family head, the whole thing scatters. So we have to pray for restoration. Joel 2 verse 25 tells us, "So I will restore to you the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust." Devil has fought the families to delete the family world, but it's not possible. Whatever you've lost in terms of family, association-wise, biological, socially, spiritual, extended family, you have tried to regain it. Remember, that was what Jesus Christ came to do, to reconcile us with God. And that's why we were told that you can pursue, overtake, and recover. Jesus did not come to shame sinners. He came to recover sinners, to help sinners, to save sinners. All have sinned and conscious of his glory. So what are we saying? Whatever you've lost before, you can reclaim it back. Prayerfully. We have to pray. The first prayer point today, besides, the only potent one we have is prayer. And that is the only one that will sustain you. I tell people, you can send your prayer to your future. When it gets there, it will wait for you. And when obstacle comes, it will override this obstacle. That's the opportunity of Jesus. We pray. My Father, my God, you can unmute yourselves. My Father, my God, every area of my life that I've been found wanting, please correct in the mighty name of Jesus. Restore my relationship with my families, if it's broken. Restore my relationship with my society, with my spiritual family, with my biological family, with my extended family, and all that. It behoves you to pray it, and it will be done. Provided it's the will of God, because not everything that is the will of God. No matter what you pray, if it's the will of God, the opposite, that will be it. So, but I know that the blessings of the Lord comes and adds also, and that's our portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, wherever biological, socially, spiritually, family I have lost in my past for due to negligence, due to anything, provided it's your will, Let me regain it back in my name of Jesus. Pray. Commit yourselves. You have power to decree a thing and to come to pass. Provided it's within the agreement you have with Lord Jesus. Pray it into your life and it will come to pass. Father Almighty, we lift up our situation with our fellow human beings. In every way we see it and heard, Father, correct in the name of Jesus. Let everything be put to shape. Let destiny be restored in the name of Jesus. Provided it is according to your will. So help me God in the name of Jesus. Can I hear you share? Amen. Commit yourselves. Second prayer point. Every siege against my destiny and all the families I belong to, be lifted today in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, there are families that need to be together to prosper. But any family that is ungodly, rule it out. If you internally belong to God and you are now in God again, don't go back to that family. That's not the family I'm talking of. But if you are involved in any spiritual family, biological family, socially responsible family, extended family, then you have to begin it back. Provided, I repeat, it's the will of God. Don't take the will of God off. Because some may not survive when you go back. So, let's pray. Every siege against my destiny, because the devil is devastating destinies. Every siege against my destiny be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. I proclaim and I claim right over principalities and powers in the mighty name of Jesus. We all belong to the kingdom of darkness by way of Adam's and Eve's misbehavior, but thank God will be removed from that according to the Bible to the kingdom of light. And we shall remain in the kingdom of light in the mighty name of Jesus. Third prayer point, you can pray it at home. My Father, my God, please destroy every yoke in my life affecting my family. Whatever yoke in my life, in your life, be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever yoke, whatever stagnation, whatever setback, whatever generational curse that has made you or made me not to be that which who God has created us to be, we destroy by the reason of our mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We proclaim supremacy over principalities and powers. Every witchcraft in our life be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak to our future to amend, to be perfect in the mighty name of Jesus. We call on the elements of the day and elements of the night to walk in conjunction with our destinies in the mighty name of Jesus. We shall not lack any good thing in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.